last week, in spite of the races being canceled and kind of the uncertainty of where the rest of the series goes, you're still dropping the hammer and training and testing hard.
Yeah, I mean, that's my job. That's what I get paid to do. So definitely going to, you know, still train as if we're going back racing soon. And that still might be the case. So you never really know. Everyone's freaking out about this. But, you know, it could be over soon. We don't know yet. So just playing it day by day and just keep it on the grind. That's for sure.
Yeah, so how has the whole coronavirus thing affected you thus far?
You know, at first I was like, just watching the news, and I'm like, yeah, I didn't really think too much of it, and I thought people were over exaggerating, like, you know, going and buying all the food and, you know, selling out everything. But you know, I'm coming to realize it is pretty serious, but at the same time, it's still, I think it's still overhyped, and it's definitely a serious matter. They have to, I guess, somehow get through to people, and I guess that's what they're trying to do by scaring them a little bit. And I mean, we'll see if this works, but we're probably gonna have to at some point just lay low and, you know, not make any interaction with any people. So I'm sure that's gonna come into play soon, and I know they did that over in Italy or whatever. So mm-hmm. It seems to be working. They were actually losing a lot of people, and now it's stabilizing, if anything, you know, going back the other way now, so which is good. We'll learn from that, and, you know, that'll start coming into effect soon. And yeah, hopefully we get back racing soon. It's pretty boring now.
Yeah. Have you rushed out and stocked up on toilet paper?
It's funny because I don't have much toilet paper, so where do I get it, right? So even paper towels I'm running low on, so it's not really a good time to be running low on that kind of stuff because everyone is panicking and getting it. So that's actually been a struggle. I've actually been working on trying to get some of that stuff.
You go straight from the shower toilet to the shower?
Yeah, just do a little rub and action with your hand.
So how is outdoor testing going so far?
I mean, good. I found a good setting with the bike, and we're just putting in the time now, making sure the fitness is there. And we've had a lot of time on Supercross, so we're trying to put our time in on outdoors, especially with this break, and it's going well. We're putting in our motos and you know, getting back to that raw outdoor speed that we need to have for the racing. So don't even know when we'll be racing that. That might be delayed a little bit too. So whatever it is, we're gonna keep putting in the work and be ready when it's, you know, time to go.
When you go from Supercross to motocross, you know, what is the biggest hurdle to overcome? Do you get like arm pump from going so fast, or?
No, I think Supercross, even though it's pretty short, it's really demanding, you know. So it's not too hard to transition that way, I think, mm-hmm. fitness-wise. But definitely have to get used to the longer motos, and it's just a different change of pace. It's pretty much wide open and not really technical anymore. So it's a little bit more of hanging it out and getting that speed back, because Supercross, it's pretty technical, so you gotta, you know, be pretty precise there and just efficient on the bike. So outdoors, you kind of just let it hang and go for it.
Mm-hmm. What are your thoughts about the outcome of the series? If they just clipped it right now, would you feel a little bit robbed, or would you be okay with it?
Yeah, of course. I mean, I wouldn't be complaining if I had the red plate, that's for sure. But had that bad race at Glendale at the Triple Crown, and I think if it wasn't for that, actually, I'd probably still have the red plate. But you know, it is what it is, and I don't see the racing coming back really anytime soon, so could be wrong, but that's just the way I see it. So I think we're at a standstill here, and who knows, maybe they just, they'll wipe the series, even the former D-class, just, you know, won't crown any champions and come back next year. So it's interesting. It's all up in the air right now, so it's gonna, you know, keep riding, stay on point, and I guess we'll see what happens soon.
Last question, with everything on a standstill and everything kind of like up in the air, how do you stay motivated?
It's a good question. Right now it's pretty early, so it's nothing much has changed, but I'm sure, you know, you know, a month goes by and we're like still, you know, unsure of what we're doing, it's I'm pretty sure it will be hard to, you know, stay motivated, especially if we don't have any racing coming up. It's like, what do we do here? Do we take time off or do we keep trucking along? But at this point, we don't know, so we gotta, you know, keep on point. And I think until we have a definite answer, we're gonna, you know, keep it as planned.
Is the last question, is the beard like a coronavirus defense?
The beard is that's one way to put it, but another way is we got this off time, no podium speeches, some interviews. I guess I wasn't prepared for this. I would have shaved maybe, but I'm just having a little bit of fun with the beard, see what it can do. Maybe trim it up a little bit and see if I can run it for a little bit.
Nice. Hey, thanks a lot.
Yep.